people believe that aliens do exist and that UFOs are evidence of aliens. To date, quite a few people have claimed to be kidnapped by aliens, and Roswell's video images of an alien autopsy shocked the world. It turned out to be a manipulated video, but many people still believe it's real. So far, there has been no scientific or objective confirmation of the existence of aliens. Now, there's even a religion that follows aliens, turning alien existence into myths. So it seems more scientific to be skeptical of the existence of aliens. So what about aliens? Well, first, let's talk about stars and planets. A star is a celestial body that generates heat and light on its own. In the solar system, our sun is a star because it produces heat and light on its own. A planet is a celestial body that orbits a star and does not produce heat or light on its own, such as the Earth, Mars, and Mercury. A planet where life could exist is called a Goldilocks planet. Too close to a star and it gets too hot. Too far away and it gets too cold. So the perfect distance is crucial. In addition, if the planet is too small, there's no atmosphere to protect life. If it's too big, it's no longer a rocky planet, but rather a gas-type planet in which organisms cannot exist. So the size of the planet should be similar to Earth. If you look up in the sky, you can see a lot of stars. As many as 5,000 can be seen with the naked eye, but that's only a fraction of the total, which is anywhere from 200 billion to 400 billion stars in our galaxy alone. Each star is accompanied by a planet, and according to researchers at the University of California, Berkeley, who analyzed observations from the Kepler Space Telescope, there could be up to 40 billion Goldilocks planets similar to Earth in our own galaxy. It is estimated that there are more than 170 billion galaxies in the observable universe alone. Each galaxy contains a myriad of stars and planets. The number of stars in the universe is estimated at about 10 to the 22nd. That's 10,000 times more than all the grains of sand on the desert and beaches of Earth. It's said that a very small portion of these stars have a similar amount of energy as the sun, an estimated 1%, the scientific community thinks it's actually closer to 5%, or 10 to the 20th are similar to the sun. If you calculate only one planet with a similar environment to Earth orbiting each of these stars, then there are 100 times more Earth-like planets than the grains of sand on the beach. If even only a small part of these Goldilocks planets contain species, there are as many chances for life as there are grains of sand on Earth. What if the environment were not similar to Earth's? Could life still exist?
Even on Earth, life can be found
in diverse environments. Deep water, extremely saline layers, severe cold, like the Antarctic Ocean, deep down underground, even in harsh temperatures of more than 400 degrees near volcanoes. So there's a possibility that life might exist even if it's not a Goldilocks planet with a similar environment to Earth. This makes the chances of life even greater. In observable universes, the actual number of planets is much higher than we had previously calculated. Beyond that is an unobservable universe, and the universe is expanding, further increasing the possibility of life. With all these possibilities, it's almost inconceivable for life only to exist on Earth. Wouldn't it be selfish to have life only on Earth?